Cena. I'll take cholera, dysentery, sunstroke, fleas in my bed, Adams in my hair, but I cannot take politicians. I wish you well, by heaven, I wish you well. But I don't envy what you're up against. Your man better stay with us until you get back.
I wasn't prepared for all this excitement. The Prime Minister's waiting for you. I want you to know before you see him that he missed a vote of censure in the House of Commons yesterday by only a few votes. I want you to know also that I'm on General Gordon's side.
You mean there's hope, sir?
I mean nothing of the sort.
Let's put all that aside. There's just one thing matters. Did Gordon or did he not receive a direct order to return?
He did.
Could Gordon or could he not be standing there in front of me?
He could.
Then, Colonel Stewart, does your presence here confirm or deny Gordon's total disobedience?
It confirms it.
It's blackmail. Blackmail. A man, one man in the middle of Africa, is blackmailing the British government into a course of action it wouldn't otherwise choose to take.
I don't agree, sir.
You don't agree.
Is it really blackmail? And one man, a long way off in a besieged desert town, calls to you and says, allow these tens of thousands of human beings to be slaughtered if you will. It's your decision. But allow me the privilege of being slaughtered with them. You see, sir, if Khartoum is allowed to die, then Gordon will die with it. It may be blackmail. And if it is, then I'm for blackmail.
Send in Lord Wolseley.
And I think how history will record someday that the decision of an empire were made only by greedy businessmen, scheming generals, and conniving politicians.
It's up the Nile for you, Wolseley. Up the Nile to save one stubborn madman. But let me tell you, if you do a Billy Hicks on me, if you take a British army into Central Africa and present me with any portion of a disaster, then don't come back. Am I clear?
You are clear.
Colonel Stewart, inform your General Gordon that the British army will be sailing as quickly as possible for Cairo.
Thank you, sir.
Colonel Stewart's man, Khalil.
Sir.
We didn't want to come to the palace. This is informal, but it's serious. General, people are afraid.
They have a right to be. What about this Walif army?
Why, the hysteria. There's still enough food.
What we're short of isn't food. It's hope.
Power, you're English, you're not a government.
How long they take to make decisions? You all know how many weeks it is to London, how many weeks back. It could be another month before we have word.
I'm an old friend. You believe me. I tell you, in the bazaars I hear things. It isn't good.
What am I supposed to give them? Promises I can't keep? Tell them lies to keep up morale?
Maybe small lies. Just a few. Little ones.
Camille!
Yes, Master. Good morning. It is such a pleasant thing to be
home. Camille, what are you doing here? Where is Colonel Stewart?
Yes, Master, I do not know. But as I was saying, that little place down by the river is the most boring place to be. I'm to be home. Oh, yes. The Major Kitchener sends his greetings. Most interesting man, the Major Kitchener.
Of England with Wolseley and 7,000 men.
I don't say it isn't necessary, sir, but we've been in Egypt for 6 weeks now and the Nile is falling. What I feel I must point out is that the fall of the Nile in Khartoum comes 2 months earlier than here in Cairo, and that when the Nile has fallen sufficiently, Khartoum will be defenseless.
Thank you, Colonel Stewart. But you know as well as I do that men who have not been fully conditioned to the tropical climate simply cannot fight. They'll die. By the platoon, by the company.
I agree, sir, I agree, but couldn't you send ahead a detachment of your best conditioned men?
No, Stuart. I'm sorry. Excuse me. Stuart. Don't be too hard on Wolseley. You haven't seen his instructions.
I was there. He's to relieve Khartoum.
Colonel, I've seen the orders. He's to bring out Gordon. There's no mention of Khartoum. Wolseley knows. He's to proceed up the Nile as slowly as possible. Oh, he'll move up to Wadi Halfa shortly, yes, but he knows. He's to give Gordon every chance at the last minute to come out by his own choice.
But Gordon won't come out.
You know it. I now know it. I'm sure that Wolseley knows it. They've been friends always. That's why I say, don't be too hard on him. It's the government that's unconvinced.
I can well understand why you haven't told me this before. Why do you tell me now?
Because it's on the cards, Colonel, that this expedition will be too late. Gordon should come out. There's no one to tell him but you.
Didn't he say where they're mounting them?
He does not know, Excellency. He saw the guns arriving, that is all. You were Gladstone's judge.